Hey everybody, Jeremy Weiss here with Weiss Tech Hockey, and I just got done watching Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final between the Kings and Devils. Over the past couple of videos, we've been talking about the New Jersey Devils 2-1-2 stack on Ryan Carter's goal in the last series against the Rangers. Now, I wanted to continue along that because in this game, the Kings actually executed a 2-1-2 spread and gave New Jersey Devils all sorts of trouble with it. The Devils had a hard time breaking out of their zone for most of the game, and the Kings' first goal actually came off of a very well-executed 2-1-2 spread. So let's go ahead. I've got the game clip up, and we'll hit play. I've got it going in slow motion, so we'll watch it really quick. As you can see, nothing fancy, just get the puck in, go deep. Now watch this. I'm going to pause it right here. Okay, I'm not a commentator, so I'm going to get do the best I can with these names. But it looks like we've got Nolan putting hard pressure in. Now notice, he's kind of taking an inside-out angle, so he's on the defenseman's inside shoulder. We've got the second wave of attack, which I believe is Fraser coming in, kind of just barely see him coming in the side of the screen here. And then we've got Richardson coming in down on the far side. So Richardson is the spread man. So first man's in hard, second man's taking away the D-to-D pass, third man is reading and reacting. Now our New Jersey defenseman actually does a decent job. He's trying to hit the misdirection here, which really probably was the right play. Problem on this play is he mishandled the puck. So on a spread, your best bet is to take a couple steps towards the back of the net, then hit the brakes, misdirect, and come back out the strong side. From there, you should have your centerman reading and possibly swinging through. Depending on where the opponent's F3 goes, you're going to want to hit either a board side breakout or a middle breakout. So that's kind of what we're looking at. Now, it looked like he attempted to do it properly, but just mishandled the puck, and the Kings' forecheck was just so hard. It was hard for anybody to kind of keep up with it. So let's go ahead, we'll hit play again. So first man goes in. Now, even though the Devils defenseman tried to misdirect, didn't work because the Kings guy got on him so fast. Now look what we've got. We've got 15 taking away the spread, or taking away the D-to-D pass, and the F3 coming in late. So let's go ahead, keep it watching. Now, not only do they not get a proper breakout, but then they go in and take the puck off him. So that's just good hard work by Nolan there. And fires it back out in front to Fraser. And the next thing you'll notice, and just this is kind of a side note, but he doesn't waste any time. It's a quick release, one-time shot, just puts it at the net. And, you know, he puts, you know, work hard, put stuff on the net. Good things happen. So what we're going to do here is actually go ahead and watch it from another different angle here. So here's the initial drive. This is Nolan's hard work. Little mishap by the defenseman there, stays with him, and as you can see, you know, there was no option to go D to D because we had 15 coming in after the fact. So let's keep watching. Puck out front, quick release. Beats Broder. That's it. So to summarize, this goal happened because of three main things. First and foremost, F1 and F2 went very hard, put lots of pressure on the puck-carrying defenseman, as well as taking away that D-to-D passing outlet. Second, F3 read the play properly, reacted, and was in proper position when the turnover occurred. And third, the F3, Fraser, got rid of the puck quickly when the puck came out front. Quick release, one-time shot, great goal.